Truth of the matter, does Alice Go plan to admit anything or share anything in the Senate?
Well, you have to analyze her statement. She is more concerned on her safety, number one, and number two, on her right against self-incrimination. She only wants a very, very simple request. If the Senate wants to pursue their investigation and aid up legislation, they can get all the information that they want. They want from Alice Go, no? Kasi simple lang. She only wants an executive session, diba? What do you have to lose if you accede to her request, and then you will have anything you want, and you can use that in aid of legislation. Why is it that they refuse to that request? Unless they have other reasons why they do not want a secret committee or an executive session. That's the problem. That's the dilemma. Because the problem is, you ask a person to speak as a resource person, but at the same time, you instituted several charges against her. So what do you now expect from her? You want her to condemn herself before the public? You want her to condemn and say, yeah, I'm guilty. I'm this one. You know, we have a constitutional right to be guaranteed against self-incrimination. We have to understand that. If you did not file any criminal case, of course, she will always help or assist the Senate in its quest for the truth and investigation. That was always my advice to her. But now there's a great dilemma.
But the problem with Alice Go is from the very beginning, she was lying. I mean, that's the big problem. When I interviewed her, she told ABS-CBN, ang nanay niya ay ang kasambahay na hindi niya kilala. And then when she faced the Senate, she actually named who her mother was when they released the birth certificate. And considering she was under oath in the Senate.
No, okay. I'll answer that. First, how do we say that she's lying if she believes that? Because the problem is, unlike in the courts, when a person is testifying on certain matters, you do not say, hey, you're lying, and you have to admit the truth because I do not agree with you. You're lying. But the truth is, what if she believes that? Now, if the prosecution or the other party believes that...
So what does she believe? I'm curious. What does she tell you?
She believes that her father told her that her mother is that woman. Now, another thing.
Nakasambahay. Na yung kasambahay.
Yes. Because the problem is the prosecution.
But why would she say in the Senate that her mother is the one listed in the birth certificate with a Chinese name?
She never told us anything about that woman, Chinese name. That was the allegation. The problem is, like, during the first stage of the hearing, they were asking, do you know Sheila Go? Is she your sister? No, she said, eh, hindi ko po alam. I-check ko po. Now you're saying, they were saying at that time that she was lying. Kapatid mo, hindi mo alam. That's the problem, eh. Because if you do not agree with her, you will just simply say, you're lying. But the truth is, ngayon, we know, hindi na talaga kapatid, even if they go DNA testing, which is reading naman, hindi niya talaga kapatid, biological. So, how can we now say that she's lying?
Biological kapatid, but Go ang apelido ni Sheila. Yung tatay Go, si Alice Go, iba ina.
Iba ang tatay, iba ina. They're not related by blood.
So ang Sheila Go...
Ang point ko lang, they were insisting at that time that she was lying. That her testimony was incredulous because you don't even know who your sister is. Eh, magkasama kayo since how many years? But the truth is, hindi ka talaga alam because they just met when she was 15. So, Senate to under oath ka. So you have to check. Ngayon, because of what she did, she was now judged or convicted na being lying or guilty and so many other things. Ang problema, you have to rebut the testimony by other evidence. Kung if you believe a person is lying, you present your own evidence. You do not accuse
the person. But Wesley Go is her brother.
Biologically. Sa tatay, yes. Oo. Because Wesley is the son of when the Chinese one, the Chinese girl yung Chinese woman, yung when, I don't know how, when Li Li or Li when like that, something like that.
But then in the Senate, when the birth certificate was shown, that's what Alice Goh said. That was her mother.
Because that was what she was made to believe. Remember, we have to see.
No, where... what was she made to believe? Nanay niya kasambahay o yung Wen Li Wan? Ano ba?
No, ang nanay niya yung nandito sa birth certificate, yung Amelia Lial. That, yun ang kasambahay. Oh.
Pero yun ang kasambahay? Yung Amelia Lial?
Yeah, oo.
Yung nanay ni Wesley Goh, hindi na si Amelia Lial.
Yun nga, yung nanay ni Wendy Lee, hindi, ay yung nanay ni Wesley Goh. The mother of Wesley is Wendy Lee Wewen, yung Chinese. Oo. So they're not related sa mother, sa father lang.
Okay.
So, if ever there is a problem with the birth certificates, whom shall we fault with this? Kasi, you remember, at that time, they were all minor children. So, do you expect a young boy like Wesley or a young girl like Alice not to believe the assertion of the father at that time? So,
okay. Let's move on to, I mean, what is more urgent at the moment is why did she even try to escape?
No, you know, I really appreciate the line of questioning of Senator Bong Revilla. He asked, Alice, tumakas ka ba talaga o itinakas ka? Kasi if we have to analyze the statements of Senator Bong, he is also in doubt as to whether she really tried to escape or she really escaped.
What's the truth? What did she tell you? Did she try to escape or did somebody from the pogo industry tell her, umalis ka na, baka may maamin ka pa?
That's why we want an executive session. Kasi on my part, pardon me, but I have an absolute privilege, lawyer-client privilege. I cannot reveal really what is her what she confided with me. But these things she can easily handle during the executive session, di ba? That's why, what's wrong with that, di ba? Why they accede to that?
Oh, okay, so clearly you are appealing for an executive session. Why is Alice Goh choosing to remain at the PNP Custodial Center? I believe the bail is only, I mean, below 200,000 pesos, an amount she can afford. Why is she choosing to stay there instead of being moved to the Senate?
First and foremost, her prime consideration is her safety. Consider she believes that there are threats in her life, so her safety. And considering that me as a lawyer, I have a long line of history of how I trusted the PNP Custodian Center on how they handled a person of high profile interest, like how they secured.
So you don't believe she would be safe in the Senate?
I believe that she's safe in the Senate and she's more conveniently placed there because, well, that's the facilities, there's air condition and the sister is there. May makakausap siya, she will have somebody to confide with. But the problem is, what I'm trying to say is, I do not have any history or experience with the Senate as to how they handle their high-profile cases and all. Because I never handled the client in that facility. Unlike my experience in the custodial facility and in what we are seeing in the media and history, they can very well protect their VIP clients. That's the very main consideration. And of course, the order of the RTC to maintain the status quo that she be detained the PNP Custodial Center.
All right. So, Attorney David, will she be attending the next hearing? Is there another hearing? Or you would only like her to attend if it's an executive session?
That is not our prerogative because right now she's under detention. Whenever the PNP, upon the request of the Senate with the approval of consent of the RTC, she will be compelled to attend. The question is, what will she say unless there is an executive session?
All right. I do hope to speak with you again. Thank you so much for joining me today, Attorney Stephen David. Thank you.
Thank you, Ma'am Karen. Thank you.